processes.
Usually you start out as a computer tech, you know. I mean, most people start out at the technician level doing, you know, local land support or help desk support, and then you just kind of, you know, move up the ladder, just depending on which way you want to go with your career. I mean, some people don't want to manage. You know, you want to be a, you want to do database stuff, and that's all you want to do. You don't want to mess with, deal with managing people. You know, I mean, that's really the difference in being an engineer or a technician and a manager is you still do the engineer technician stuff, but you just jump into managing people and managing projects and stuff like that. So, after becoming a technician and engineer, you either want to get kind of move away from the daily detailed technical stuff, and you want to get more into generalization and being able to have people to know that stuff for you. I mean, that was the driving force for me, you know, but that's kind of the path, I guess. You know, anywhere from a associate's degree to a master's, you know. A lot of times managers will usually have some sort of certifications, you know, on their journey to management. You pick up, you know, Microsoft certifications or, you know, some kind of server, HP or Dell, or, you know, whatever they were specializing in before they got to management. But a lot of certifications, a lot of self-study, and a lot of, you know, just hands-on experience. The ability to manage people, that's a big one. I mean, manage, because you run into so many different personalities and egos. There are a lot of egos in IT, you know, technology. Everybody wants to know it all, you know. But that's a big one. And just all of the, you know, a lot of the broad technology skills. I don't think you necessarily have to have the detailed how-to stuff, but just, you know, what's going on in the industry. Keep abreast of that, you know, be able to suggest, you know, to do R&D on certain types of technology and stuff like that. So you can go, I guess, several different ways, maybe some type of officer, chief technology officer, chief information officer. You know, the term manager is loosely used in the IT field. I mean, you know, you could, in some companies, IT director is a little bit higher than IT manager or systems manager. You could move, you know, gradually move up the scale there. A lot of managers, if they're doing it for a long time, break off and do their own business, you know, because they know how to, they kind of got a little more experience on dealing with people and being able to manage projects. Yeah, it just depends on your aspirations, where you want to go. If you want to stay in the corporate world, there's quite a few levels you can move up.